ट्रिग्नोमेट्री इज एक्चुअली कमिंग फ्रॉम थ्री पार्ट्स. द वर्ड ट्राई, यू नो, इज ट्राई मीन्स थ्री. एंड गोनो, गोनो कम्स फ्रॉम साइडेड. एंड मेट्री कम्स फ्रॉम अ वर्ड मेट्रॉन विच मीन्स मेजरमेंट. सो ट्रिग्नोमेट्री इज बेसिकली स्टडी ऑफ थ्री साइडेड मेजरमेंट, और इन अदर वर्ड्स ट्राइंगल्स. नाउ यू मस्ट हैव हर्ड अबाउट दीज टर्म्स, बट नाउ आई एम एक्सप्लेनिंग ऑल दिस. सपोज वी आर हैविंग अ ट्राइंगल हियर, एंड this is always applicable to a right angle triangle. Okay, so in class 10 we are doing trigonometry for right angle triangles only. So this is 90 degrees and the unknown angle is represented by a Greek alphabet which is called theta. Okay, so this symbol that you find here is written like this, and this is theta. Okay, this is a Greek alphabet. Now when the unknown angle is theta, right, the angle is unknown here as well as here. So I am showing you two cases where the unknown angle is here as well as here. Now there are two ways of explaining this, so please listen here carefully. Suppose the unknown angle is here, theta, so then this becomes the base of the triangle, and this is the perpendicular and this is the hypotenuse. Okay, but you look at the second figure, when the theta is taken here, right, then the base of the triangle is here, perpendicular is here and hypotenuse here. So in the two figures, what do you observe is that hypotenuse is same, but the base and perpendicular will change depending on the position of theta, the unknown angle. So if theta is here, the base is here, and if theta is here, the base is here. So this is very important for you to understand, otherwise your problems will go wrong. So hypotenuse is same, depending on theta, this becomes your perpendicular. If this is theta, this becomes your base and this becomes your perpendicular. If this is theta, this is base, this is perpendicular. Now there are six trigonometric ratios. Three are called basic and three are called derived. There are three basic and three derived. Now what are the basic ones? The basic ones are sine, cosine and tangent. Okay, the three basic ones are sine, cosine and tangent. So sine, this is the full form, but we use only the short form. So we write it as sin. So it's not pronounced as sin, because actually the full form is sine, sine. Similarly, the full form is cosine, but I don't use cosine, I use only cos. Similarly, tangent is tan. So we are using only the first three alphabets. Now what is sine theta? Sine theta is the ratio of the perpendicular and the hypotenuse. Cos theta is base by hypotenuse, and tan theta is perpendicular by base. So these are the three important basic ratios of trigonometry. And in order to learn this, there is a technique. You have to learn up this statement: some people have curly brown hair, some people have curly brown hair, teeth polished black. Okay, so it's very easy to learn up this sentence. Some people have curly brown hair, teeth polished black. So how do we use this statement? Some people have. So sine is perpendicular by hypotenuse. Sine theta is ratio of perpendicular by hypotenuse. Curly brown hair. So C, cos is base by hypotenuse. And T, that is tan, is the ratio of perpendicular by base. Understood? Sine is P by H, cos is B by H, and tan is P by B. Right? So by this, we can learn of the three basic trigonometric ratios. Now once we know the basic, these are only reciprocals. So the reciprocal of sine is cosec, full form is cosecant, but we are using only short form cosec. The reciprocal of cos is sec, and the reciprocal of tan is cot. Okay, once more I am repeating: reciprocal of sine theta is cosec theta, sine and cosec. Reciprocal of cos is sec, reciprocal of tan is cot. Okay, these are the full form, secant, cotangent, but we don't use it, and you will not find this in the questions. You will find only the short forms. So what is the meaning of reciprocal? Like sine has become P by H, so cosec will become the reciprocal of this, that will become hypotenuse by perpendicular. Okay, cos is B by H, so sec is the reciprocal, B by H will become H by B. And tan is P by B, so cot is the reciprocal of that, it will become base by perpendicular. So once we know sine, cos and tan, this is easy, you just have to take the reciprocals of that. Now, in the textbook, they have not used this base and perpendicular because, as I said, depending on theta, the base and perpendicular will change. So, they have used another term, opposite side and adjacent side. Now, what is the meaning of this? That also I am explaining. If you are having a triangle and the unknown angle here is theta, okay, then this becomes your adjacent side, this becomes your opposite side. So, opposite side is the side opposite to your theta. Hypotenuse is same. Now, if the theta is here, this becomes your adjacent side and the side opposite to the angle becomes opposite side. So, you can either learn up this or this. Okay, either base perpendicular hypotenuse or opposite side adjacent side hypotenuse. So, if you are using this, then same thing,